The most fascinating thing about science is the ideas, is the lifting of the human spirit.
We can justify what we do by the technological spin-offs, and it's true. General relativity is esoteric, but you couldn't use your GPS machine without it. It turns out the effects of general relativity on the satellites have to be incorporated. If not, within a second, you'd lose all knowledge of where you were on Earth with the GPS satellite. So it's true that even the most esoteric ideas sometimes have technological spin-offs. But I think it is misplaced to argue for doing fundamental research just because of its technological spin-offs. The questions themselves have to be worth asking to be able to spend the money on. But having said that, it is absolutely true that our current standard of living vitally depends on the curiosity-driven research that was done a generation or two before. Discoveries come along that change everything when you didn't expect it, and they come along because you didn't know what you were looking for. And if we stop investing in fundamental research now, it is true that our standard of living a generation from now, our children, the legacy we leave our children, will be much poorer. And in fact, it's one of the reasons why I argue that not just to live off selling natural resources, but to think about the future, about doing fundamental research, because the countries that are going to be able to compete in the 21st century are those that invest in technology and ideas and research. So there is, of course, not just this altruistic, idealistic notion of understanding the universe. If we want to address the challenges of the 21st century, from energy to climate change, we need to invest in fundamental research now. I'm always worried about predictions about the future. And people always ask me, what's the next big thing? And I say, if I knew, I'd be doing it. But what I'm convinced of is that the most important things that we know 50 years from now will be things we had no idea about right now. Nature continues to surprise us in ways we could never have expected. Nature is much more imaginative than the human imagination is. And in order to make progress, we keep having to question nature, explore it, because it will yield those surprises that will change not just our picture of ourselves, but the way we carry out our lives. As far as I know, people don't ask the question, you know, what's the value of a Mozart symphony or a Picasso painting? Science is a cultural activity. And it's produced some of the most amazing ideas that humans have ever thought about. And the cultural value of science, of understanding where we are and where we come from, is the same as art, music, and literature. Great art, music, and literature forces us to reassess our place in the cosmos. That's what science does at its best. And if we are so impoverished that we have to stop asking questions about where we came from and where we're going, it's indeed a sad time. These are the most interesting questions that humans have ever asked. And by comparison to the money we spend on many other things, that is, in my opinion, much more useless, the investment is very small. And so if we are at the point where we have to say, look, we can't stop asking these esoteric questions that change our picture of ourselves, then it's a sad time for humanity.